have an original thing of energy that we need to feed our brains. Even our hominin ancestors that were before us had a need for this energy to feed their bodies. And for us, that is agriculture, food and beverages. And it started with fire, which kind of put us at the top of the food chain, and with agriculture. This is a temperature timeline that goes well before 800,000 years. And you can see this last little portion, 12,000 years, the temperatures stabilize in a nice range. Before that, the temperatures were so extreme, and it wasn't until the last little ice age, which you can see depicted right before the temperature stabilized, that we were hunters and gatherers. We ran around and migrated to follow food, and we were not at the top of the food chain. We were kind of like vultures or hyenas, so we would wait around till other mammals and species would kill their food and do things, and then they would wait. We would wait and watch until they left, and we would run in and gnaw on the bones and eat the bone marrow out of the bones to get our nutrition, because we were afraid of being eaten ourselves. And then with fire and agriculture, that flipped the switch and we changed. But this is a Goldilocks event that happened 12,000 years ago, which started the agricultural revolution, started farming. And agriculture is the world's oldest economy, 12,000 years. And they call it the agrarian society. I don't know how many people know that or have thought about that, how important agriculture is, and it's the most successful and longest running world's economy. When the bubble pops, what we do is a bailout and repeat the bubble. In psychological terms, repeating the same thing over and over again, hoping for different results, is what psychologists call insanity, right? Running out of resources, we are eating ourselves to death, and we're losing that connection with our planet. 75% of all agriculture, or the food that we produce in this world, comes from 12 plant species and 5 animal species. That is not a very diverse food system. And it creates a problem because we're putting all our eggs in one basket. We need much more diversity in our food industry. This is from the World Business Council for Sustainable Development and the EAT Forum, which motto is to globally reform our food system. And there's multiple facets and reasons why this needs to be. It's a lack of diversity, it's a lack of food security, it's a lack of many, many factors. It's a wicked complex system. And I have a lot of people say, which goal do you like? Oh, I like the red one, I like the purple one. Well, you're missing the boat, because most humanity sees these goals as linear and lateral goals, because humans are linear, lateral, and local thinkers. All 17 of the Sustainable Development Goals have to do with agriculture, food, and beverages, every single one of them. And 12 of them intensively focus just on food and agriculture. Most people don't know that. They don't understand the relationship. If they just focus on poverty, they don't understand what applies to that and how far-reaching that is. And so I want you to understand the bottom layer is just water, land, how we do agriculture, how we get our food, how we get our energy, and then our society, and then lastly our economy, and then bringing all the goals together. They're not to be seen individually. They're to be seen as a system, of which I've talked about. I want you to understand that. The other thing I want you to understand, that if we do business as usual, and we just continue with fossil fuels and oil and gas, and just renovate our buildings every once in a while, we're going to invest, I think it says, $89 trillion regardless, just by renovating, renewing, business as usual. That money will give out anyway by 2030. But if we do it the sustainable way, And with good agriculture, smart farming, with innovative exponential businesses, we only need to invest $14 trillion US dollars more to reach the goals and stay below that degree of warming, which has profound effects all over the world. So I want to leave you with two things, and that is, how do you stop and reverse global warming? That's not the oil and gas industry. They're number 6 or 7 on the list. The number one way is to globally reform the food industry, the entire food industry, from farmer to packaging to food security, the whole system of it all. The second is to empower women. The third is to empower girls. And if you don't know why, we need to talk later, because I'll explain it to you, because the majority of women and girls are the majority of farmers in our world. I'm sorry for all the Italian and German farmers here today. You're not the majority male farmers. And the last is to rethink refrigerants, because that's how we cool and extend the shelf life of our food, and it is creating enormous greenhouse gas emissions in our world. And I leave you with one final thing. I want to touch your heart with something that I'm passionate about.